Hello children, how are you all? Hope you all are well and good. So today in this video, first we are going to learn about how to copy any object on the drawing area. So for copying any object, I'm going to draw a shape on the drawing area, and let's fill some color inside the shape. Okay. Now if we have to copy this drawing, then first of all we have to select this drawing. See, I'm selecting the drawing. The drawing is selected. Now after selection, you have to go and click here in this copy option. You can see here on the clipboard the copy option is given. Here you have to clicked, and now after clicking you have to click here on the paste option. See, as you clicked on the paste option, another star came. Okay. Now again, if you have to bring another copy of the star, then no need to press on this copy option. Again, if you press on this paste option, another copy of the star will come. So like this, you can click over here on the paste option, and you can bring stars again and again. Okay. So like this, you can copy and paste any object on the drawing area. Now after this, we will learn how to resize any object on the drawing area. So for resizing means we can increase the size of this object as well as we can decrease the size of this object. So for that we have to select the object. See, I'm selecting the object, the object is selected. Now after selection, you have to go to this resize option. Here you can see the resize option in the image group. Here you have to click. See, I've clicked the resize option, and after clicking the resize option, you can see a small window come. In the small window, you can see horizontally and vertically it can be increased. So for that you have to make a click over here, and you have to delete this 100. And you have to type, if you have to increase the size, then you have to type some number which is greater than 100. Suppose I am typing 200. Okay. After typing 200, you have to press OK. See, after pressing OK, the size of the star has been increased. Understand? So like this, you can increase the size of the star, or if you want to decrease the size, you have to again go to this resize option. And in the resize option, you have to type here some number less than 100. Now I am typing 50. After typing 50, make a click on OK. OK, you see, the size of the star have again become smaller. Got it, children? Now children, after the resize option, we will learn how to skew a figure in MS Paint. So for skewing this figure, I have drawn a flower. For skewing this flower, we need to select this flower. I'm selecting this flower, and after selecting the flower, we have to go in this resize option. See, I am clicking on this resize option, and this particular options came. Now you can see below the skew option is given. Skew by degrees. Suppose if you want to skew this flower horizontally, then you have to type here suppose 50, and vertically if you want to skew this flower, then you have to type here suppose I'm typing 20. Then I'm pressing OK, and see, the flower has been skewed. Okay, the flower has been skewed. So like this, you can skew it by the degrees given over here. Suppose I am skewing it by 30, and then again vertically I am skewing it by 1, and then OK. See, the flower is skewed more. So like this, you can skew any drawing from this skew option in the given inside this resize option. Okay, so after learning the skew option, we will learn how to rotate a drawing in drawing area. So for rotating this drawing, we have to select the drawing first. See, I am selecting the drawing. The drawing is selected. Now after selection, see here, the rotate option is given. You have to make a click. Now if you want to rotate it on the right side, if you want to rotate it towards the right side by 90 degree, you can click over here and see the picture is rotated towards right by 90 degree. Again, if you want to rotate the picture towards left by 90 degree, you can click over here towards left by 90 degree. See, the picture has gone to its previous position. Again, I am rotating it towards left by 90 degree. See, rotate left 90 degree. See, the picture is rotated towards left by 90 degree. Okay. Now, children, again I am selecting the picture. Okay. Now we will see what is rotate 180 degree. If we make a click on this rotate 180, the drawing will be rotated fully upside down. Okay. Again, if you click on this rotate 180 degree, see, the drawing will rotate upside down. Clear? See, I am doing it again. I am clicking on this rotate 180 degree. See, the drawing is been rotated by 180 degree. And again, I am clicking on this 180 degree. See, the drawing has been rotated. Now, children, we will learn what is the flip vertical and flip horizontal option. Now, if we make a click on this flip vertical option, it will rotate 180 degree again. See, it is flipped. A mirror image of the previous image is coming. Just like that, if we make a click on this flip horizontal option, see, the mirror image of the previous image is coming. Again, I am clicking on flip horizontal, see. Again, I am clicking on flip horizontal, see. You will understand it if I rotate it right by 90 degree. And see, now I am doing the flip horizontal. See, the mirror image is coming. Okay, again I am doing flip horizontal, see, the mirror image is coming. So, this was the flipping options. Okay, this was the flipping options which we can use for any of the for any object on the drawing area. If we make it flip vertical, then see, flip vertical. Clear? It will be flipped vertically. If I rotate this by left 90 degree and if I flip it vertically, means upside down, then it will rotate, it will create a mirror image upside down. Okay. Understood, children? So, in this chapter, it was up to this. So, see the video again and again so that you can understand what I have explained. And if you are having any doubt, please tell me in my next doubt clearing class when I'll be explaining you all these things. Okay? Thank you.